Hello and welcome to the spoken tutorial on modeling turbulent flow in a lid-driven cavity using OpenFOAM. In this tutorial, I will show you solving turbulent case in OpenFOAM and plotting streamlines in Paraview. To record this tutorial, I am using Linux operating system Ubuntu version 12.04, OpenFOAM version 2.1.1, and Paraview version 3.12.0. To practice this tutorial, you should have some basic knowledge of turbulence modeling, knowledge of how to solve flow in a lid-driven cavity. If not so, please refer to the relevant tutorial on our website. This problem is identical in geometry and boundary condition to the lid-driven cavity problem discussed in the basic level tutorial. Please make a note, this problem is already set up in PSOFOAM solver in OpenFOAM directory. The boundary conditions are, the lid velocity u is 1 meter per second, and we are solving this for a Reynolds number Re equal to 10,000. We are using a transient solver for incompressible turbulent flow of Newtonian fluids called as PSOFOAM. Now let us open the terminal window by pressing Ctrl plus Alt plus T keys together. In the terminal window, type run and press enter. Now type cd space tutorials and press enter. Now type cd space incompressible and press enter. Now type cd space PSOFOAM, note that F here is capital, and press enter. Now type ls and press enter. In this, you will see two folders, les and ras. Our problem setup is inside ras folder, which is called as Reynolds averaged stress. Our folder name is cavity. Now, type cd space ras and press enter. Now type ls and press enter. You can see the cavity folder. Let me clear this off. Now type cd space cavity and press enter. Now type ls and press enter. You can see three folders. Zero, constant and system. The initial conditions are specified within the files in the zero directory. Now let us take a look at the files in the zero directory. To do this, in the command terminal, type cd space zero and press enter. Now type ls and press enter. You can see the files named as epsilon k nut nu tilde P, R and U. These files are to be kept as default until the inlet parameters don't change. If any changes are to be done, please refer to the tutorial on simulating flow in a channel using OpenFOAM to calculate these values. Now type cd space dot dot and press enter. Let me clear this off. Let us open the constant folder. To do this, type cd space constant and press enter. Now type ls and press enter. In this, you will see the polymesh folder containing the geometry of the case inside blockmeshdict and the fluid properties. In this case, you will see two more files other than transport properties named as RAS properties and turbulence properties. Let us open these two files. In the terminal, type gedit space ras properties and press enter. Let me drag this to the capture area. Scroll down. RAS properties contain the Reynolds average stress model for this case, which is kept as k epsilon. Close this Now in the command terminal, type gedit space turbulent properties and press enter. Scroll down. The simulation type model for this case is kept as RAS model. Close this. Now let us open the transport properties model. To do this, in the terminal type gedit space transport properties and press enter. The transport model we are using here is Newtonian and the viscosity is kept as 1 e raised to minus 4. Close this. We are not changing the geometry in this case. So we need not go inside the polymesh folder and look at the blockmesh dict file. It can be kept as it is. In the terminal type cd space dot dot and press enter. We will keep the system folder default as there are no changes inside it. Now we are done with the setup. We can mesh the geometry. To do this, in the terminal window type block mesh and press enter. Meshing has been done. Now we can run the solver. To do this, in the terminal type PSOFOAM and press enter. The iterations running can be seen in the terminal window. It may take some time for the iterations to stop. The iterations running will stop at the end of the time step. To visualize the results, let us open the Paraview window. To do this, in the terminal type Paraform and press enter. This will open the Paraview window. On the left hand side in the Object Inspector menu, click on Apply. You can see the lid driven cavity geometry. A common visualization is surface plots. Change the display to surface in the column and from the drop down menu, change from solid color to capital U. You can see the initial condition of velocity. Now, on the top of the Paraview window, you can see the VCR control. Click on the play button. You can see the motion of the fluid inside the cavity. You can also toggle on the color legend from the left hand side top of Paraview active variable control menu. Click on it. You can see the color legend. Now to visualize the streamlines on top of the menu bar of Paraview, go to filters, common and stream tracer. Click on it. On the left hand side of the object inspector menu, you can see apply. Click on it. You can see the streamlines at the center of the lid driven cavity. You can also change the orientation in which the streamlines are viewed. To do this, scroll down. You can see the seed type. Let me shift this to the right. Change from point source to line source. You can see the X, Y and Z axis which are visible. Select any of these axes in which you would like to view the streamlines. I will select the Y axis and click apply. You can see the streamlines along the Y axis. Similarly, you can select the X axis and plot the streamlines along X axis. Now delete this. You can also plot the velocity along X and Y axis using plot over line. To do this, go to filters, data analysis and plot over line. Save the data as .csv from the file menu. Click on save data. You can plot this data in LibreOffice spreadsheet or any other plotting software of your choice. Now let me switch back to the slides. The results obtained can be validated by using results of Ghia et al. For Reynolds number RE equal to 10,000. That's all we have in this tutorial. Let us summarize. Turbulent flow in a lid driven cavity and plotting streamlines in Paraview. This brings us to the end of the tutorial. As an assignment, modify the grid size of the cavity, change it to 100-101 and visualize the results in Paraview using streamlines. Watch the video available at this URL. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have a good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops using Spoken Tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT-MHRD Government of India. More information on this mission is available at this URL. The script is contributed by Shekhar Mishra and Chaitanya Talnikar. And this is Rahul Joshi from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for joining.